and forgive Heights, them, I guess.
Well, it's interesting. Christian Heights, the only multiple. He's got two. Lee Coghlan, Matty Thornton, Adam Parry, Hamish Lay, Pascal Craig, Braden Blake, Brodie Montague and Seb Green have all got one. Yep. And Nicholas Doolan's kicked the goal for the Dogs.
Set for a second half start at Sandhurst by 62 points on Big Footy.
Big Martin hits it down straight away to Dole. Have a look at that. Runs onto it. Has a bounce. Goes to 45 and kicks into the goal square to, well, I'm not sure what. Wasn't the best kick. In the end, it was a chance down there for McKenna to take it under the pump, and the Dogs will get out of trouble. Work to Masoudi. Oh, Masoudi's hand pass intercepted. Has to push it along the ground. Just outside forward 50 for the Dragons. Ball's bundled over the line and out of bounds for a throw-in. That was a sensational start for the Dragons.
I think the word you're looking for is anticlimactic.
Oh, well, I was up.
Yeah, and it was brilliant sudden, from Dole.
And then all of a sudden the parachute didn't open.
The kick wasn't up, unfortunately.
So there you go. Throw-in just outside forward, 50 for the Dragons. Fitzgerald goes through the pack, went without the football. Parry's in making a contest, got rid of Masoudi. Going through also was Ruth for the Dogs. He can't take it. Dogs player can eventually, but he's locked up in a tackle. That was McKenna, and the umpire's going to ball it up. Same spot, just outside forward 50. Minute gone, third term, no addition to the score. Dragons 71, Dogs a 9.
Third man up was Wharton, won it down decisively. Player at the back is Alex Wharton. Thought he might have been injured. He's just going to ground, collecting his breath as well done from Price. Marks it with Canolan flying over the top. Exel runs to 55, sends it inside the forward 50. Thornton and Blake both there for the Dragons. Neither could take it. Then Craig ran into Thornton. It came out through Clough. Martin applies a big clearing fist. And Donnie won't be happy about that because it's in his bonnet.
His car. No. Look out. And he's in it too, Donnie.
Oh, no. Marto's going to have to...
The crutch will come out the window in a minute. Look out.
So the ball will be chucked back in right in front of our broadcast position. Up they go. Thornton.
I thought the doc was going over to make sure Donnie was all right, but I think he might just have been standing.
Well done
position.
From Wharton. Alex Wharton runs to 45, fires and kicks a ripper. That's the way to get you started in the second half. Two gone, third term. Sandhurst 11-11-77, Gisborne 1-3-9. Wharton with his first of the afternoon. That is thanks to Innes Motors on Big Footy, Bendigo's Fresh FM.
Well, I wonder if he had some of his father's lollies and snakes at half time there,
from
Alex Wharton.
Massive bag they
had. We saw that huge bag in the reserves, didn't we? I reckon that would hold a few hundred snakes, so perhaps he's had a couple and he's full of beans at the beginning of this third term.
Fair enough. 11 goals to the Dragons, 10 individual goal scorers so far.
Been the story of their season. They've had about 23 players kick a goal for them in senior footy this season.
Ball up again in the centre. Martin nonchalantly got it down to Holmes, who got it to Dole. Repeating it again. They work it to half forward, the Dragons. Turned over, though. Masoudi got it to Fitzgerald, same hairstylist. He goes across the ground. Finds a teammate in O'Gorman. O'Gorman's got it on the wing. Little kick to Wood, and he's taken the mark. Now he plays on for the Dogs. Tommy Wood, centering kick to half forward, and he's found a mark. Chance down there. Mark, no, not paid. Play on's the call. Gisborne player took it. I think it was touched, so the mark wasn't paid, and the Gisborne player was penalised for caught with the footy. Meanwhile, the Dragons move it directly across the ground where it comes off hands and goes over the line and out of bounds.
25 players, in fact, have lined up for Sandhurst coming into the game today and kicked a goal. You add Lockie Tardrew and Hamish Lay to that mix this afternoon. So 27 goal kickers for them this season.
It's a lot.
Out of 34 having played a game.
Yeah, that's a lot of them. From the throw-in, Dragons all around the contest. Work to height. He goes to half forward. Defensive punch is okay. It was crumbed by Parry. He was tackled but strong enough to get a hand pass away. Got it to a teammate who was tackled, and the umpires deemed he was pinged, caught with the football.
Yeah, had prior there, did Nick Stagg, according to the umpire.
So Dogs free kick, Ruth to take it at centre half back.
So Ruth goes to McKenna, who shares it out wide by hand with Nick Doolan. That is a very poor ball down the line from Doolan. Didn't settle over the footy, skewed off the side of the boot, and it's out of bounds on the forward. He brought back into play by Tardrew, who's going to have to do it all again, because he kicked it to Price, didn't come back around to the mark correctly. So Tardrew kicks the exact same ball inboard to Exel. So Exel's got the football. He comes down the line. Good kick from Martin. Just forward of centre wing. Plays on with a handball to Tardrew. Running through the wing. Goes inside forward 50. Lovely delivery for Thornton. Thornton by hand to Wharton. Wharton to the square. Stag. Marks it 15 metres out. And the leading goal kicker for the Dragons this year will go back and try and kick number 30 on the season.
He loves a goal, doesn't he, Stag? And he enjoys a bit of celebration too, but...
Yes.
I don't think he'll celebrate too much here because it's... He loves to celebrate most when it's the big-time goals, and really this is just going to further stretch the lead for Sandhurst in what's been a one-way display today.
Hasn't kicked one today, comes in and keeps it that way from 20 metres out. That's a shocker. And the head goes down, and he hasn't moved. 11-12-78, Sandhurst. 1-3-9 Gisborne, 5.5 gone third term on Big Footy. This isn't going to hurt them today, this issue. It will at some point, though.
There's a bit of a goal-kicking virus today, you'd have to say. Lee Coghlan and Nick Stagg missing goals they'd usually kick.
Kick out towards defensive 50. Pack go up. No one could take the mark. And the umpire will ball it up. He said that no one was looking like getting it out of the congestion.
Scores level between Midiamo and Bridgewater as well. 5-6 apiece in that game, thanks to Wade Roberts.
Wow. Interesting. Was Ladson playing today in that?
Not sure.
I'll check.
There you go. Meanwhile, chance down there for the Dogs to momentarily get out of trouble through Ruth. Throws it on the boot, goes down the wing, grandstand side. But only as far as Harry O'Mara, who takes the mark. Centering kick to Height, who marks, plays on. Long into the forward pocket to Stagg. He couldn't take the mark. Throws it, lays a tackle. Upsets his opponent, then goes back and gets it. And was slung just as he got out of hand pass. Ball's gone over the line and out of bounds for a throw-in.
Another really interesting result, and it took place here at the QEO this afternoon. Gisborne have beaten Sandhurst in the A-grade netball, 54-47.
Fair dinkum.
Yep, 7-goal win. 7th fee first, and the Dragons go down as... This time Green wins it away from the contest and finds Blake at the point of the square, and Braden Blake will go back and kick his second of the day.
And to answer your question, Jock, no, Rick Ladson didn't line up today for Bridgewater.
They've dropped a few key forwards over the year, haven't they, with injury.
Here's Blake, will come in, 15 out, and pops it through with all the ease in the world. Braden Blake with his second, 12-12-84 Sandhurst, 1-3-9 Gisborne, 7 gone third term, thanks to Aussie Disposals on Big Footy. Bendigo's Fresh FM, Blake's second of the afternoon, and... He is a player, Jock, with a big future. Just the way that he attacks the ball. You see it and you know when those kind of Pioneers kids come into senior football and they attack the ball like Braden Blake does, that they're going places.
Yeah, I like the ones that go into senior company and look right at home with all the physical contact. You know, they're playing men and not just other boys. So, you know, they're going from playing against blokes that are 65 to 75 kilos to blokes that are... 85, 95 kilos, makes a difference. From the ball up, and again, a great take out for the Dragons. Long inside forward, 50. Good Mark McKenna going back and taking the grab. In defence, he swings wide and finds a teammate, Clough. So Clough's got it in the back pocket for the Dogs. Now he runs on. Comes down the line. Oh, big ask to Fitzgerald. Made a contest, ball off hands over and out of bounds for a throw-in. So the ball will be thrown back in across half forward for the Dragons. 8 minutes gone, third term. They're 12-12-84, Gisborne 1-3-9. All thanks to Aussie Disposals.
Ball chucked back into play again, repeating the A-grade netball score. It was Gisborne by 7 goals in a key win for their finals hopes this afternoon at the QEO. Parry out the back of the stoppage, swings it by hand to Montague, back to Parry, busts through the tackle, gets a right football, top of the square, Thornton back with the flight, Belcher there, Green out the back, strolls into an open goal. It beat the pack, and Sebi Green read it beautifully over the back of the contest. He gets in and kicks his second of the day. 13-12-90, Gisborne 1-3-9, 9 gone, third term, all the nines. Thanks to Aussie Disposals on Big Footy, Bendigo's Fresh FM.
Just too easy there for Seb Green, a lack of pressure applied on him. And as you said, Joel, just footy smarts. He read the flight of the ball beautifully. He backed himself, he took the game on, and he... just backed his judgment to know where the ball would land, and he found it right in the goal square and the easiest of goals you could hope for.
They kicked to a key forward. He couldn't take the mark. A good rover was where a good rover was supposed to be, and a goal resulted. Far better than 75 mongrel sideways possessions that get you nowhere. Ball up centre of the ground. Fitzgerald gets it for the Dogs, throws it on the boot towards half forward. Can't take the mark. Massoudi He met it in the air, got out of hand pass, but it was stolen. Price has got it for the Dogs. Runs to the middle, goes back. Oh, might have just beaten McKenna. Still a chance for the Dragons. 40 metres out under the pump of the Dogs defence. McKenna got it. Went wide and found a teammate. He stood up well, McKenna. He's had a good match so far. He's worked very hard, the vice-captain, trying to marshal an under-pressure defence. They go to half-back. Out of side, Namark's taken over there by...
Payne.
Sam Payne.
Yep.
We're number 56. My age, maybe. He goes down the line and Martin marks it half back for Sandhurst.
Plus four.
Oh.
Gee, it was a dodgy...
Shut up.
Dodgy one. Exel inside defensive 50. The Dogs with an opportunity. Exel worked it out. Wharton slipped over. Canolan straight on top of him and gave away a free kick for pushing him in the back when he was on the ground. So
that's pushing him in the ground.
Interesting one. Price just comes to a complete stop inside defensive football. I mean, inside defensive 50 with the football, I should say. Coughlin's got it now. Grandstand side, comes down the line. Green the target, lost it in the sun. And Grabak the other way, took the mark. His centering ball dangerous, but Fitzgerald is paid a mark he didn't take. Blake sort of looks up and says, oh, I don't know about that, as he chucks the footy back to Matty Fitzgerald. Down the line now, they work it to O'Gorman, the Dogs. His kick toward half forward, met with a big double fister from Martin, who lays a good tackle on his opposite ruckman in Wilson, and the ball is locked up. Left half forward, 65 out from the Gisborne goal. It is Sandhurst by 81 points at the 11.5-minute mark of the third term on Big Footy.
Absolutely. Ball up just outside the Dogs. Forward 50-metre arc. Plenty around the contest. Going to be hard to get it out. Somehow height squirts out. Little underground, clever kick to Holmes. Holmes under the pump, gets out a good hand pass and comes back and gets it. Super play, Holmes, and then delivers to Thornton, who marks, plays on, hand pass to Parry. Parry slightly off the side of the boot, goes into the pocket where a Gisborne player's, well, probably Fraser might have stepped over the line. I think he's pretty happy to see it go over the line. It was under the pump. It'll be thrown in deep in the Dragons' forward pocket. How good was that from Blair Holmes?
Yep. And the clever, that really clever handball from Blake too, who read the situation perfectly.
Yeah, absolutely. Throw in. Plenty in that forward 50 for the Dragons. Stags after it, picks it up, gathers it, goes around on the left foot. Oh, kicked across, goal was okay. Finds a teammate down there in...
Coughlin,
who kicks a goal. And James Coughlin joins the list of goal kickers for the Dragons this afternoon.
Yeah, good to see James on the end of one there. Jockey is a player who is always doing the team thing, usually closing down players, so I'm sure he'll enjoy a rare goal.
11 goal scorers out of their 14 for the Dragons. 14-12-96. Gisborne 1-3-9-12.5. Gone third term, thanks to Innes Motors.
Only your second goal for the season, James Coughlin.
So...
good reward for him.
The Dragons chipping away over halfway through this third term. But they've added four goals. Better than their return in the second quarter.
The ball goes up in the middle of the ground. Well done, Hand, who just did the old backhand around the corner to Exel. Out wide for Green. Dragons come forward here again. Montague got it out of sight, centre wing. Wheels around, gets it up toward Tardrew. Running past is Exel, feeds him the handball. Exel inside forward 50. Overcooked it there for his targeting Craig. Dole there with him. Ruth on ground level for the Dogs. Oh. Well done, Martin. Cleared the space for Dole, who runs in and snaps a goal. All too easy for the Dragons. 15-12-102. Mitch Dole with his first of the afternoon, which comes as a little bit of a surprise. He has been busy enough. Gisborne a 1-3-9 margin, 93 points. And that is thanks to Aussie Disposals on Big Footy, Bendigo's Fresh FM.
Five goals to zip in this term for Sandhurst, so they've had all the play and we've only gone 14 minutes. So, again, they're just well on top. It's been an emphatic display by Sandhurst today.
Yep, and yet another individual goal scorer. That's 12 for the Dragons today. They might set a new record.
I don't know what the record is.
No, I wouldn't have a clue.
They had 14 in a game earlier this year.
Ball up in the centre. Thornton down conclusively to height. Throws it on the boot. Gets it inside forward 50. Pascal Craig all got out of hand pass. Just a little bit behind Holmes. He couldn't take it, but he's been grabbed high. And Blair Holmes has got the free kick for the Dragons. 45 from goal.
He hasn't kicked one today, so Blair's welcome to go back and kick a goal.
Needs to have a shot. Come on, Blair. He's made all the right moves to pass, but he's always going to have a shot. So Holmes will have to kick it from 50. 45-degree angle. The skipper comes in. Obviously reckons he can make the journey, and he has made the journey, and he has kicked the goal.
He just polished that one side of the ball and let the reverse swing do the rest.
Beautiful work. Blair Holmes joins the list. That's 13 individual goal scorers for Santos. I'm glad there's something to get us excited about here at this stage. They go to 16-12, 108. Gisborne 139, 15 minutes gone, third term, thanks to Bendigo Bank.
So a 99-point lead now to the Sandhurst Dragons, and 13 goal scorers, as you say, Jock. I didn't think Blair Holmes was going to get the journey on that one, but he just kicked it perfectly. It was a beautiful kick.
So Harry O'Mara, Lockie Tardrew, Alex Wharton and Dane Spear all haven't, in fact, Dane Spear hasn't kicked a goal this season. Josh Hand, the other one. So we want one of those boys to kick a goal. Here is Tardrew, inside forward 50, out the back McKenna, 30 out from the Dragons goal once more. Ruth in trouble, tackled by Height, got it out to Fraser, well done. Oh, short kick. He was nearly run down as well in the direction there of a teammate. Couldn't find the footy. Doolan had it stolen by Wharton. Alex Wharton flicks the handball out the back to Dole, who runs in, snaps it goal. Martin on the line. Can he take it? No, Craig can, and he snaps a goal. Craig second. So he mucks us up completely.
Not all that excited, yeah.
17-12, 114 Sandhurst, Gisborne 139, 16 gone third term, thanks to Winners Motors on Big Footy, Bendigo's Fresh FM, and it's just sheer weight of numbers now in terms of the inside forward 50s for Sandhurst, Jackson.
It sure is, and to show just how much they're dominating, they've kicked four goals in the last 3 minutes, have Sandhurst, so they're on fire. This could be a 12 or 13 goal term, I reckon, the way they're going.
Big Timmy's,
7 already in this term.
Big Timmy's down at full forward, and he hasn't clunked one yet, a goal.
So who have we got? Joel Wharton hasn't kicked one.
No.
Martin hasn't kicked one. Stagg hasn't kicked one.
And those three always kick one.
Yep. There's some likely targets there.
Just a bit of a delay getting the ball back from over the fence.
Josh Hand was the leading goal kicker in the reserves last year. He hasn't kicked one all season.
We're back underway. Up they go. Thornton, big leap and a big clunk. Got it down to a teammate. Height can't get it out. Umpire balled it up again. Right in the middle. The only little muddy patch right in the middle of the Queen Elizabeth. I'm not sure why that is. Aren't these drop-in wickets?
No, they were going to put a drop-in wicket in, I think, the council. Then they realised it was going to be too expensive.
They dropped it.
Yes, they dropped the idea.
Fair enough. Ball up centre of the ground. Chance down there for Wharton. Got it over to Tardrew. Hand pass backwards. So the Dragons have got it. Centre of the ground. Kicked towards half forward. Players lose it in the sun. Joel Wharton almost kicked off the ground. Went away from him. Can't take it. 30 out from the Dragons goal. Wharton got it. Hand pass to Martin. Couldn't find him. Tapped away by Belcher. Over the line out of bounds for a throw in. Big Mardo wanted deliberate, and it was deliberate. Would have been paid in Melbourne.
I think he was going for. He was trying to get it for the toward the goal line. Belch for a rush behind, but nonetheless.
Missed. So throw in deep in the Dragons' forward pocket. Up they go. Martin the thump out. Who's on the end of it? There's a few Dogs defenders there, but they're under the pump. Good pressure from the Dragons' forwards. They force a ball up 25 metres out, maybe 20 metres out from the Dragon goal. It is absolutely. I don't think. Have the Dogs been forward of centre yet this quarter?
I think maybe. Yeah, that's about it. As this from the stoppage, Coughlin has a wild shot on goal, out of bounds on the full. He has kicked one this afternoon, so we don't want him to kick another one. 17-12, 114 Sandhurst. Gisborne 139, margin 105 points at the 18.5 minute mark of the third term. Joel Peterson, Jock Clark and Jackson Saunders with you on Big Footy this afternoon. Baker drives a low ball outside defensive 50, picked up by Ruth, got it by hand to Doolan, got it by hand to Grabak, running through the centre of the QEO. Here they go forward of centre Gisborne, and there is absolutely no one home. The lights weren't even on. So O'Mara marked, he got it to Price. Price is going to switch it, and that is an absolute laser to Height. Height goes by hand to Green. Green to Wharton. Wharton to centre half forward looking for his brother. That was Alex toward Joel. Cut off by Ruth, and Ruth's got it at centre half back. So a really nice passenger play for the Dragons. Breaks down at half forward and Ruth repels the danger.
So Ruth from half back goes to the wing. Grandstand side. Holmes with strength through the pack. There's a whistle on play. Holmes grabbed high, said the umpire, and he'll take the free kick for the Dragons. So the skipper will drive them forward, goes with a pass to Joel Wharton. Skinny takes the mark. Keen to play on, dances around or then goes back. Swings wide on the left foot, kicks inside forward 50. Where are the Flyers? No one could take it at the back. Chance in defence down there for Baker for the Dogs. He takes it, gets a hand pass wide, couldn't find a teammate. Here's the Dragons, 35 metres out from goal. Can they keep it in close to the boundary line? They can. No, they can't. And it'll be thrown in.
Fresh live BFL update, boys. Golden Square by 26 over Castlemaine. Kangaroo Flat by 21 points over South Bendigo. And Kyneton leading by 92 over Maryborough.
Ball chucked back in. Height took it out of the ruck. Kicked a bag of weed inside forward 50. It didn't spin.
Good mark.
McKenna judged it beautifully. And ambles back to Baker after he took the mark. Baker down the line. Diving in on top of it there, not being able to take the football. The Gisborne player sees it over the boundary line. It'll be thrown back into play, right half forward, in front of our broadcast position. Sandhurst by 105 points, 21 gone. In the third term on a beautiful Saturday afternoon, Massoudi went up in the ruck then. That was unconventional. Harry burst through the stoppage and aimed at the poppet head with the kick. Unfortunately, got the poppet head and the goals confused. We can forgive him for that.
Yes.
And it was out of bounds on the full by a long way.
So from next week, boys, you realise that we can't say that's the Maryland end.
Yes.
You do know that.
Yep.
So
the Dogs will bring it back in through Grabac.
Have you had a selfie with Maryland yet, John?
No, I haven't. I'm old enough.
The only person in
Jacko,
Bendigo.
I could have had one with the real Maryland.
No comment.
No. Just didn't quite. I took
Play
the number.
The percentages, Jacko.
Took a number like the Coles Deli, but it never quite got to me.
Now, Leone Patterson has just updated us on the score at famous Canterbury Parks. Thanks, Leone, for the update. Eagle Hawk, 7-12-60 to Strathfield save 5 goals, 8-38. So the Borough leading by 22 points in the third term.
No fairy tales in football, Jackson.
Absolutely. It's about time you blokes realised that. Here come the Dragons again as they work to Montague, who marks right on forward 50. Got it to Tardrew from 50. Goes for home into the goal square. Good mark. Absolute last line of defence from Baker of Gisborne. One-on-one contest. Baker won it. Little clearing kick to Massoudi's okay. Massoudi's got it just outside the defensive goal square and runs on the little warrior, still full of petrol. Look at him go. Kicks the halfback out of side. They've turned it over, though. Taken by Exel. Got it to Martin. Martin in board. Wanted Lee Coughlin. Kicked it over his head. Still got it inside forward 50. Height takes it. Work to Montague. Montague back to Tardrew. Where are they going? Across the ground to O'Mara. Kick towards goal, boys. Now they do. O'Mara's kick. Little one. Up goes Parry. Couldn't complete the mark. Hand pass from Coughlin. Came out wide to Sebby Green, goes with another one, taken by Exel, who turns on the left foot and kicks it out of bounds on the full. What are you burying your head about?
I'd want him to kick a goal, because then we narrow the list of goal kickers that haven't kicked one.
Did the hard work, kicked it out on the full. Penalty free kick, Dogs will take it. Last line of defence, 17-12, 114 Sandhurst, Gisborne 139, 23 gone, third term, thanks to Bendigo Bank.
So Exel, Tardrew, O'Mara and Han and Spear, the five players who haven't kicked a goal this season, three of them in their first game for the club this afternoon. Canolan, big fly at halfback for the Dogs. There's about 20 players around this football. They're all chasing kicks.
Get your structure back. Look, there's no one again in one whole half of the ground.
Yeah, just Timmy Wood who's saying, boys, come back here. You can see him gesturing, gesticulating to his side. Here's Wharton, takes it off the pack, slams it towards goal and puts it through. 14 individual goal scorers now for Sandhurst. We keep adding to this list. 18-12, 120 the Dragons. 1-3-9 Gisborne. Joel Warden's first of the day. He's 21st of the season at the 24-minute mark of the third term. Thanks to Aussie Disposals on Big Footy. Bendigo's Fresh FM.
Fresh Live, BFL, Loddon Valley Football League update, actually. I'm not the one on Rice, so the latter will do. Late in the third term, look at this for goal-kicking yips. YCW 9761, they lead Pyramid Hill, but Pyramid Hill have kicked 1-goal-11 late. Oh! In that
1-11.
Absolutely terrible kicking. They're down by 44 points.
That could end their finals hopes.
Yeah, as they deserve to be kicking like that. Meanwhile, from the ball up, Dogs trying desperately to get a take out from the middle, and they'll earn a free kick, so they will. They play on quickly. Taken by Fraser. Kicks high to half forward. Up they go. Oh, good mark. Dragons player back there taking it well was Coughlin. Played on quickly with a hand pass. Might have got a teammate in trouble. Goes back to Coughlin. Goes further backwards. Now a chance. Taken over there wide as a Tadru with the football. Who's got it? Swings it across the ground. They switch play to Wexel. He's off and running. Good bounce. Then he goes towards half forward. That's a good kick to Skinny Wharton with space at half forward. Plays on into the forward pocket. Wanted Thornton. Just put it out in front of him a little bit too far. Heights there. Can't keep it in. And Pye will throw it back into play forward pocket for the Dragons. And I'll blame Bear Thornton then. Why didn't he lead down the middle of the ground? He's led to the pocket. He's led to the angle.
There's plenty of space.
Plenty of space. Demand the corridor, boys. Throw in forward pocket. Dragons in front, 120 versus 9.
Alex Wharton, handball to his brother. Joel's going to kick two in a row after not having kicked one in the first half. He doesn't. He just misses it to the near side. 18-13, 1-2-1 Sandhurst, 1-3-9 Gisborne, 25 and a half gone, third term on Big Footy. That's thanks to Aussie Disposals. A couple of close games. We'll update you all of the scores at three-quarter time with Jackson Saunders. It is a 112-point lead to Sandhurst here at the QEO. Gisborne with the one goal for the afternoon through the agency of Nick Doolan. They fly high at halfback again. Canolan is a long way from home. Thornton for the Dragons. By hand to Green, by hand to Tardrew. Exel ran under the football. He's got support in Coughlin. Wheels around and does well, does Jack Exel. Sends it up toward half forward. Wharton flew high, couldn't take it. Masoudi ground level, handball to Ruth. Busts through a few tackles, sends it into the centre of the ground. Good kick. And Trotter's got it. Defensive side of centre for the Dogs.
Plays on quickly with a hand pass. Not allowed. Got to go back. Paddy Trotter and take the kick. Almost at halfback, goes directly across the ground to Clough. Clough takes the mark, goes directly across the ground to O'Gorman. O'Gorman takes the mark. Now goes 10 metres forward into the centre of the ground, finds a target. Crosby's got it, plays on, kicks it inside forward 50, taken by Doolan. Doolan goes into the pocket, chance here for the Dogs. They've got a pick-up shot at goal from the pocket, goes right across the face, marked by Cody Price. And Price will clear to half back. Mark taken by Josh Hand, and the Dragons, well, they should have been out of trouble. Exel's hand pass went up in the air slightly. Oh. Now it allowed the Dogs to come back in. They take the footy, but they're tackled. And I think the umpire will say it's a dead heat, boys. I'll ball it up. When you get tackled by Adam Parry, you are tackled. Umpire will ball it up across half forward for Gisborne. 27 gone, third term, 121, plays 9, Dragons in front.
Shadows starting to creep over the QEO on a beautiful winter's afternoon for football. Montague feeds it by hand to Stagg, who was running out of play. And I think he said, golly, that was a poor kick.
Practicing his crow calls, I think.
Who was that on the TV?
Graham Kennedy.
It was Graham Kennedy.
You wouldn't remember. He was the king.
Yep.
He was the king.
Well, we won't be impersonating those. It is a family show. So here's Belcher inside defensive 50. Clough in the blue boots. 40 metres out from his defensive goal for the Dogs, who have really struggled this afternoon and have been thoroughly outclassed by a consummately professional Sandhurst side. Baker's got it. He's going to drive it up the line for Trotter. Trotter toward half forward. This is good movement here from the Dogs. Doolan dropped it at the critical moment. Couldn't find the football. Wharton fires in. That was Joel Wharton for the Dragons. Can't extricate the footy in a ball up. Out of sight, between wing and half forward, Gisborne into attack. They trail by 112 points at the 28.5-minute mark of the third on Big Footy.
Tell you what, boys, it'll be tough to find the gun of the day thanks to the Bridge Hotel, won't it?
It will be.
It's clearly a Sandhurst play, but it's even put their hand up and they win it again. Lee Coghlan's got it in the middle, threads a hand pass, long kick inside forward 50. At the back, Dole got rid of his opponent, got rid of him illegally, said the umpire. Dogs free kick in the back pocket.
Ooh. Didn't give the ball back.
No.
Had it stolen from him.
And he wasn't pinged for it, didn't he? Oh, anyway, it doesn't matter. The Dogs kick directly across the ground, so they've got possession in the back pocket still. Spent a fair bit of time there in defence. It's a high kick to half-back in front. Good mark. Well done, Alex Wharton. He's a mature player for a kid. Now he plays on, runs around, goes inside forward 50. Out comes Thornton. Couldn't take the mark. Got the crumb. Got out of hand pass. Sanders player grabbed high.
Taken high.
We'll take a free kick.
Seb Green.
Well, no good Seb Green taking. He's already kicked
pass
two.
It.
Needs to hand pass it. Where's big Timmy? Timmy Martin and Nick Stagg. Always kick a goal.
Yep.
Pressure's on those two in the last quarter.
Absolutely.
Seb Green, 25 metres out, directly in front. Goes back with the cricket run-up. So he won't kick into the player on
the
mark.
Not much of a bowler either, Seb.
And he comes, fires at goal, puts it through, and he's the high scorer on the park at this stage. Seb Green with his third. Takes the Dragons to 19-13-129, leading the Gisborne Bulldogs 139. 30 minutes gone, third term, thanks to Aussie Disposals.
Now that Huntley, the top of the table clash there today, I can sense the frustration of the Huntley supporters late in the third term because they've kicked eight behinds in this quarter.
Oh.
And they trail Leechville Gumbauer by 50 points, but they've had their chances. Huntley, they've kicked six goals straight, have the opposition. 15 goals, 7.97, Leechville Gumbauer to Huntley, 6.11, 47. But, as I say, the Hawks have had their chances.
Scores were tied between Bridgewater and Midiyama at 5.6.36 apiece early in the third term at three-quarter time. Bridgewater 13-6, lead Midiyama 5-9. 84 to 39 after it was tied at 36.
Yeah, all and you blokes looking for the miracles.
From Wade Roberts says, Bridgewater are playing mean. Living up to their billing is the mean machine. Ball goes to the ground here at the QEO and we'll have a ball up. 118 points the margin.
So Bridgewater with key players out today.
Yep.
Top of the ladder, pulling the pants down from the second side.
Their real challenge is next week against Calaville. Green feeds it over the top to Montague from the stoppage, who tumbles a rolling ball home. And Montague's already kicked a goal today, his second. Sandhurst 2013 133, Gisborne a 139. We have played 31 and a half minutes in the third term. Thanks to Aussie Disposals on Big Footy, Bendigo's Fresh FM. And just a reminder, if you missed the A-grade netball score here at the QEO this afternoon, it was Gisborne coming away with a surprise victory by 7 goals over the Sandhurst Dragons.
And talking about close games, it's a close one between Serpentine and Newbridge. 6 goals, 8, 44 apiece. So it can't get any closer, in fact. Thanks to Mick Ketterer and Dean Gordon for those updates.
Really good effort from Serp.
Absolutely.
Newbridge need a win like a hole in the head, especially with Morong and Pyramid Hill struggling. So siren sounds meanwhile here at the QEO, and it is Sandhurst who are dominating in this game, and Gisborne did not score in that term. Sandhurst kicked 10 goals 2 to lead at 2013 133 to Gisborne 139 at three quarter time. The final break, then we'll come back. We'll have the last quarter action. We'll head into the winners' rooms and bring you all the scores from around Central Victoria through until 6 o'clock on Big Footy, Bendigo's Fresh FM.
Christian Hyatt, Adam Parry, Braden Blake. It's just, yeah, they're just dominating every position on the ground. I'd be interested to think whether there's one position that Gisborne actually winning at the moment.
Ruth, Fraser, Doolan, Crosby and Baker, the best for Gisborne so far. And Wilson's competed well in the ruck. He gets a chance to go up here against Martin again. We start the last term at Sandhurst by 124 points on
and
Big Footy.
And straight away they get the takeout. It's work to Alex Wharton, who kicks long inside forward 50. Marking contest. No one could take the mark. Gisborne defender tackled to the ground. Pack develops. Umpire will ball it up 40 out from the Dragons' goal. So already within about 14 seconds, the Dragons straight to within the heart of goal. Up they go. Blake, in fact, worked to the front, got it down. Comes to Stagg. Stagg gets through the traffic. Oh, slipped. Had to just throw it on the boot. Went nowhere. Now's the chance for The Dragons as it's worked to Dole. Oh, he slipped. Now he's tackled. Gets it out. Comes to Parry. He didn't slip. Gets it to Skinny Wharton. Back to Parry. Shrugs the tackle. Runs almost back to the centre, then around the body. Kicks into the forward pocket. Worked over the top. Chance down there for Height. Fires it goal on the left and just puts it to the right-hand side for a minor score. So the Dragons start with a little one. They go to 20-14, 1:34. Gisborne 1:39. Minute gone. Final term. Thanks to Innes Motors.
They should know Sandhurst by now. Don't pass it to the blokes that have already kicked goals. McKenna drives it long outside defensive 50. All dogs around this contest. They've got numbers everywhere. Wilson by hand through the pack. Out to Payne. Almost ran into trouble. Hesitated. Went back the other way. Standing start toward half forward. Canolan there. All too easy for Price, who takes a mark at centre-half back for the Dragons. Centre of the ground for Wharton. By hand back to Price. No, feigned the handball. Sold some candy. Got it to Coghlan. Coghlan to the top of the square. Blake in from the back. Can't take the mark. Stagg and Parry both in the area. Good tackle, Stagg. Ball on the deck. Paul Hutchison crosses the arms and says, give it to me and we will have a ball up.
Don't any of the umpires getting mentally drained this afternoon? They've got their trivia night on tonight.
They do. So that's a big one. I believe it's the Dean Goodridge, Dale Caldwell, the teachers' table that takes it out every year. They've basically got a syndicate on the whole thing. This time, Wharton for the Dragons. By hand to Holmes. Holmes, top of the square. Thornton in from the back. Couldn't take it. Roving around the corner is Stagg. Hasn't kicked one this afternoon. Paddles it to his own advantage. Dives back on top of it. Handball to Craig. He's kicked two this afternoon. He's gone there. Good tackle, Ruth.
Yep.
And Shannon Ruth, who's been pretty handy this afternoon, will take the free kick. Last line of defence for the Dogs. They trail by 125 points at the 2.5 minute mark of the last.
Goes backward, finds a teammate in defence of the goal square. He goes towards halfback. Oh, I thought that hit the grass. Umpire paid the mark. Another little short kick, and Fraser's got it at halfback for the Dogs. Plays on, hand pass out. Finds a teammate out there in Pat Drotter. He's pushed over the line with the footy. It'll be thrown back into play across half forward. Just outside forward 50 for the Dragons. So 3 minutes gone, final term. It's the Dragons by absolutely plenty. Martin beautifully down to Height. Wide towards Dole. Couldn't find the handle. Eventually the Bulldogs get a couple of defenders over. Then they're under the pump. The tackling from the Sandhurst forwards has been pretty good this afternoon. They have been able to lock it in their forward area for long periods, but just the same, you wonder whether it might have been better if the whole thing had been kept more open. Ball up, forward pocket for the Dragons. Blake wins it down, taken by Coghlan. Throws it onto the boot into the goal square, and Thornton in front, where a good forward should be, takes the mark on his chest.
Got the socks up, Matty Thornton. A little bit unusual for him.
Bear normally got him down, hasn't he?
Yep.
So Bear Thornton, oh, good angle. 3 metres in from the boundary line, but he's only about 10 out from goal. He should still kick it. Comes in, fires a goal, and Bear has kicked number two. So two goals to Thornton and another one to the Dragons. They go to 21-14, 1:40. Gisborne 1:39. 4 minutes gone. Final term. Thanks to Bendigo Bank. Still 14 individual goal scorers for the Dragons.
Two more fresh live Loddon Valley Football League scores coming through thanks to Susan Roberts and Chris Garlick at three-quarter time. Inglewood by 13 points over Morong, so the Panthers still a chance in that one. And YCW leading Pyramid Hill, but the Bulldogs mounted a bit of a challenge in that third term and trail by just 24 points at three-quarter time.
Well, back in the middle, a couple of interesting games in the LVFL. Martin won it down to Craig. Craig's handball turned over. Dogs come back the other way. Here's Nick Doolan. Been okay this afternoon inside. Forward 50 to Wood. Lovely bit of play. Yep. Best build-up for the Dogs all day. And Wood's marked at 40 out slight angle, kicking to the city end.
A good takeaway there by Gisborne from the middle. They haven't done that too often today, but this might be their first opportunity to take it from the middle and get a goal a moment later.
17 goals on the season for Tommy Wood. For their second this afternoon, and a bit of reward for effort for the Dogs. He comes in from 45 and misses. Just to the left-hand side. 1-4-10 Gisborne, 21-14, 1:40 Sandhurst. We have played six in the last, thanks to Aussie Disposals on Big Footy, Bendigo's Fresh FM.
The Dragons run it out of defence. It's worked to O'Mara. Might have taken his eyes off it, lost the footy. It's in dispute across half forward for the Dogs. Can they win it back and make something of it? Payne makes a contest. Plenty of numbers around the football. Too many Dragons. Too slick. Work back to Price. Good hands. Got it away. Back to Skinny Wharton. From half back, Skinny goes on the left foot. Gets the lead from Parry towards the wing. Couldn't quite trap it. Now a chance for the Dogs to take it through Baker. He's tackled. Lost it. Good work, Parry. Height comes in. Picks up the crumb. Goes wide to Price, who's well down the ground. Dogs under the pump in defence. They go across the ground to Baker. And he takes a good mark under the pump from Lay. So well done, Baker. Marks it half back. Oh. Poor kick. Kicked it, turned it straight over to Hand. Hand goes back. Deep inside forward 50 for the Dragons. Plenty up. No one could take the mark. It's 40 from their goal. They press. They've got numbers. Blake wins it. Got out a hand pass. Then the player he gave it to was tackled. Lost it. Turned over. Dogs have got it. They go across the ground. And the mark's taken by O'Gorman.
Couple of good minutes here for Gisborne. O'Gorman's kick down the line was a shocker. And Lay intercepted. Kick and a half from home at left half forward, Hamish Lay.
Seems with the Dogs about every fourth or fifth kick's the letdown.
Inside forward 50, Thornton up among two, couldn't take the grab, out the back, Dogs with numbers, trotter by Hand quickly to Rogers, he got it off around the corner, standing start, a high ball down the line from Grabak, roving it beautifully, O'Mara, his handball too hot for Lay, over the line, out of bounds, will be thrown back in. 130 points is the Sandhurst lead, seven gone last term on Big Footy, ball to be chucked back in grandstand side.
So the boundary umpire to do his job. The Dragons well in control of the contest. Really, the final score and how many goal scorers, individual goal scorers the Dragons have is probably the only interest left in this competition, this game for the next half hour. Kick across the ground to Montague. Able to pick it up. Got plenty of time. Goes back and gives it to Hand. Hand from the centre of the ground. Goes towards half forward. Good mark. So the Dragons have got it. They'll come inside forward 50 again, although it's a lateral kick. Lee Coghlan in space, marks, gives it to Harry O'Mara, who plays on, fires at goal, goes towards the goal square, up they go. No one could take the mark, worked wide. Was it Stagg?
Green.
Green.
Stagg gave it to him.
Stagg gave it to him. Not what we wanted. Wanted the other way around. Green from a standing start, 30 outs, put it through for a minor score. 21-15 the Dragons, 1-4 Gisborne. 8 minutes gone, final term, thanks to Innes Motors.
What you get for being unselfish, Nick. So ball brought back into play. Dogs do well. Worked outside defensive 50 now in the hands of Ferrugia. The shadows lengthen here at the QEO. Been a dark day all round for Gisborne, but it's been a very nice one for the Sandhurst Dragons.
Ooh, race
and weather-wise, Wood inside the forward 50, has the pace over Spear, did well, handball back to Canolan, had to get rid of it, did, turned it over though, Exel back the other way, did well through traffic, been assured so far, Jack Exel, disposal might have let him down, but ball in hand, he's been okay. Wharton into the centre of the ground for Parry, who marked that one, he dropped one similar in the second term, another awkward kick for Parry. Hasn't been his day off the boot by any measure this afternoon. Montague set chase. He was well tackled. Went to ground. Ball came out the back. Stagg did well. Fed it out of the handball toward Height. Height, hands and knees. Shovels it back out of that contest. Fraser goes in. It'll be a free kick against Parry for the afters against James Fraser. And James Fraser's got the footy at half back. Two of them out there this afternoon. And Fraser sends it toward Tom, the other, and he's got it at half-back, outer side of the ground, and he comes back inboard and finds Clough.
I tell you what, if you say about Sandhurst, he got plenty of players that are silk. Adam Parry's rock.
Yeah.
He's just rock, you know, and he's a great foil for a lot of those players because he just goes in and gets the damn thing. I love him. Goes to the centre of the ground where Holmes takes it for the Dragons, turns, kicks long towards half forward, over there, chance for Dole, can he pick it up? He can, gets good support from Stagg who went in and later Shepherd. Now Dole wants Stagg with a hand pass, went to him, might have just missed the target, tackle laid, forward 50 for the Dragons, they all hail cabs, umpire comes in and says give it a man, I'll ball it up. 10 minute mark, final term, 141 Sandhurst, 10 Gisborne.
Ball will be balled up right half forward. And again, repeating that score from earlier, Gisborne did run out winners in A-grade netball this afternoon. Fantastic effort from the Dogs and really boosts their finals chances in the A-grade netball race. Here's Dole, leads the foot race back to the footy, picks it up on the boundary, got shoved over the boundary line, and just resigned himself to the fact that he wasn't going to be able to get up and play on, although the umpire was a little bit slow with the trigger, and the ball will be thrown back in right forward pocket. So the Dragons deep into attack once again. They've added just the one goal in this last term. Gisborne just the one behind on their score, not only in this last term, but since half-time. Through the pack, ball dispossessed. Oh, crashing in there. Really nice work from Masoudi. They all fire in there at the moment for the Dragons. Payne's there for the Dogs. Green's there for the Dragons. They both try and extricate the football. Big pack, throw about blanket over 20 of them inside forward 50 for Sandhurst. And we'll have a ball up 30 out from the Dragons' goal.
I do like to point out players with flashy boots, but I'll tell you what, the boots of Jack X
are rippers,
green
aren't they?
And yellow. They're the most flamboyant boots I've seen all year.
They were fantastic on the dim conditions here last Sunday afternoon at Bendigo Pioneers game. Rain and the lights were on. They really took full effect. And now a free kick coming here to the Dragons. And it will be Christian Hine.
Do they glow in the dark?
Not quite, but they're not far off it. They are luminescent, the boots from Exel. And they've been given a good workout in the last 6 days, him playing two games.
Luminescent boots is a phrase I couldn't have worked into footy when I started 30 years ago. Let me give you the drum.
Exactly. So here is Height, who comes in from 30 metres out. He fires and he kicks his third. No, just missed.
What?
Just missed.
Had my pen ready.
The pen was poised.
Yes.
And the eraser supersedes.
The whiteout?
No. Yep. 21-16, 142. Sandhurst, Gisborne, 1-4-10, 12 and a half gone last term, and still the 14 goal kickers for the Dragons,
yes,
thanks to Aussie disposals.
Dogs bring it out, grandstand side, big pack, no one could take the mark. Bear Thornton in there doing a little man's work and trying to rove the footy out of the pack. Can't do it, and the umpire comes in, he'll ball it up. Just on forward 50 in the old South Bendigo social rooms pocket, probably not the old South Bendigo, still their social rooms, isn't it?
Yep.
Sort of?
Yep.
There's the throw-in, plenty around the contest, Height threw it on the boot, didn't go far. Worked out to Harry O'Mara, flying shot at goal from 35 out, minor score. So a little one.
Hit the post.
The Dragons continue to pepper away.
Would have been his first for the year.
21-17, 143, Gisborne, 1-4-10, 13 gone. Final term, thanks to Aussie disposals. So far in this final term, they've kicked one goal, four. The Dragons, and the Gisborne Bulldogs have added a behind.
Ball inside defensive 50 for the Dogs. Here's Payne. He's been good today. Tried hard, Sammy Payne. Far from their worst. McKenna as well has been good. Comes down the line. Kick was touched off the boot, as you heard in the effects, Mike. Green goes through. Well done, Dogs. A high ball towards half forward. Wood battles away. In front of him, doing well, was Hand.
Good work.
Great work, Joshy Hand. Ran through the contest. Handball into the centre of the ground for Coughlin. He hands it off to Tardrew. Low, flat ball inside forward 50, marked by Craig. Craig needs to find someone who hasn't kicked a goal today. Goes towards Wharton. That's the wrong option, but Jolly Wharton or Mark anyway. So Wharton's got it. He's 35 out, right forward pocket, tight angle. Wharton will go back and try and kick his third, unless he does the right thing and pass it off to one of Nick Stagg or Tim Martin. But Nick Stagg's on the bench, and so is Tim Martin, so he probably won't do that.
It'd be very difficult to do that.
So Wharton will come in. He'll fire from 35 metres out on the left boot and miss.
Oh.
21-18, 1-4-4, Sandhurst. Gisborne, 1-4-10. The margin, 134 points at the 14.5-minute mark of the last term, thanks to Aussie disposals. On Big Footy, Bendigo's Fresh FM Saturday afternoon football in round 12 of the BFNL.
So, as the game sort of snoozes to a finish, the Dogs kick out to a big pack. Up high was Belcher, couldn't take the mark. Squirts over the back, Canolan, good tap along. Can he find a teammate? He can, but it's intercepted. Exel takes it, then he's tackled. Held without the footy. It'll be a free kick to the Dragons. Jack Exel to take it between centre and centre wing. Plays on with a hand pass to Tardrew. Plays on with a hand pass to Lee Coughlin. Back to Tardrew. Goes wide to half forward. Dragons player standing all on his own. Takes the mark. That's Lay. Now he plays on. Goes with a little toe poke over the top to Alex Wharton, who marks just outside forward 50. Puts his hand up. He's looking into the sun. Gets some leads. Ignores them. takes his time. Alex Wharton with the footy. Now he goes into the pocket, over the top. No one could take the mark. It's 40 metres out. Hit the pack well, I think. Was that Blake who took it? Kicked it into the goal square. But the Dogs had some numbers back. They take the mark. Little kick out of defence is marked by Trent Crosby.
So Crosby comes wide for Rogers. Fresh live update from Bendigo Mazda Oval, Jackson.
Yeah, it's a thriller there. South Bendigo by 2 over Kangaroo Flat. 13 goals, 7 plays, 13 goals, 5.
Good mark from Thornton. Go the Bloods. Ball on the centre wing, grandstand side. 134 point lead to Sandhurst. Snuck that in there nicely. Into the centre of the ground, Montague. Handball off to Tardrew. Handball off to Stagg. Load up, Staggy. Kick it to goal. He just chips it short. And it's a good pass to Price. In fact, it's Craig.
No good. No good, no Pascal good at all. Craig.
Don't know about
that. He's already kicked two.
Don't know about that.
And so, out at famous Canterbury Park, boys, it's still Eagle Hawk leading by 21 early in that last term. So that could still go either way. The upset's still possible out at the Borough.
So Craig comes in, left foot, kick. Did he sneak it home? I think he did.
Yes.
He did. Just for Pascal Craig. 22-18, 150 Sandhurst, 14 Gisborne, 17 gone last term on Big Footy, thanks to Bendigo's Fresh FM. They will, that'll throw a cat amongst the pigeons in the finals race, won't it, Eagle Hawk, if they do manage to get up this afternoon and beat the Storm.
And if Flat lose.
That's right.
But look at that in terms of the context of the season, that Eagle Hawk have just beaten Kangaroo Flat 2 weeks ago. They've had a massive win against Maryborough then. They've come into this game and beaten the Strathfield, say, Storm. We spoke about it this morning, Jock, that I personally didn't think Eagle Hawk were good enough to make finals. They're making a compelling case.
I think I said this morning they're not dead in the water.
They'll very much be alive.
They were the only side out of it that were the question mark. Ball up, centre of the ground. Holmes gets it. It's worked all the way back to Alex Wharton. Got it at half back for the Dragons, but he creates a space. Then he's kicking to the centre of the ground. Not good, straight to Wilson. Wilson marks for the Dogs, goes across the ground and gives it to Crosby. Crosby towards half forward. Canolan flies, can't bring the mark down. Massoudi, hands and knees, gets out a hand pass. Got it to Trotter, then he's besieged. Tackled to the ground, can't get it out. Umpire will ball it up. Just outside defensive 50 for Sandhurst. 18 minutes in fact gone, final term. The margin to the Dragons, 140 points.
So ball goes up, comes back down. Spear got it from Holmes. Handball to Tardrew. Little chip over the top to Dole. Plays on around Doolan. Did well. Sold some candy down the line for Craig. Pascal Craig, the state champ up toward half forward. I don't know what he's the state champ in, but he tells us he's the state champ. Free kick two.
No, and Stagg was off into an open goal.
Gee, the mark was a good kick from Craig because he directed it for Martin and then Stagg was at his feet, so it was absolutely perfect for what we're after this afternoon, and he gave away a free kick. So McKenna gets it. They switch it wide here, the Dogs. Fraser, handball to Krabak, hemmed in on the boundary line by Wharton. Hemmed over the boundary line, in fact. If you can be hemmed over something. The ball will be chucked back into play on the outer side. 70 metres out from the Sandhurst goal.
Double hem.
Yeah, not a textiles expert, unfortunately. 22-18, 150 Sandhurst, 14 Gisborne. Nearly time on in this last term.
So the Dogs have got it at half back. They've got a chance to get out of trouble here. Payne goes wide with a hand pass. Missed the target. In fact, sold his teammate into trouble. He was tackled to the ground. Umpire said no opportunity, so he'll ball it up between centre and centre wing out of sight of the ground.
Bartels just with his third for South Bendigo 2. They are ahead by 3 points now, 92-89, thanks to Richard Jones for the update.
Whoa, it's all happening out at, what's it called now?
Bendigo Mazda Oval.
I knew that. No, I didn't. Wouldn't have a clue. It used to be Dow Park when I was involved in it. Canolan's got it at half forward for the Dogs. Turns, goes wide, puts it out in front of Rogers. Can he run onto it? He can. What happened? Oh, stepped over the line, out of bounds. Throw in. Tell you what, when it's not working for you, it's not working for you, is it?
Can't buy them.
No, you wouldn't take a Tetz Lotto ticket with any of the Gisborne boys this evening, I wouldn't think. Throw in. Forward pocket for Gisborne. Canolan over the top. Big 40-metre punch towards the front of the goal square, but it's all Dragons back there in defence. Exel takes it. Long hand pass. Oh. Got it to Lee Coghlan. Over the top was clever. Got it to Wharton. Back towards the centre of the ground. Here they come. Lee Coghlan takes it back. Runs almost to the centre, then goes long to half forward. Delivers well. Sliding in Lee. What's he doing at half forward? Thought he was the centre half back. He's taking the mark. slows it down. Where's he going to go? Goes into the pocket, gets the lead and gives it to Parry, who's marked.
Good kick.
40 metres out on a 45-degree angle, and Adam Parry's kicked one.
Now, final sirens just sounded between Serpentine and Newbridge. A thriller. Newbridge win by 3 points, 8-9-57 to Serpentine, 7 goals, 12-54. Just repeating, a 3-point win to Newbridge.
Great effort, Bears.
Jacko, no miracles in football. Parry's kick out of bounds on the full. Last line of defence, penalty free kick to the Dogs. No miracles in football.
Eaglehawk beating Strathfield State, just an improbable, not a miracle?
Yeah, no, not a miracle.
Okay, fair enough.
Not a miracle. Mirrabarra beating Strathstorm's a miracle.
So here is Baker. He goes wide. That's a horrible ball off the boot there of Clough. It was just a hit and hope. It skewed off the side of the boot. It goes up the pool change room's race just about. And the free kick will be taken on the outer side for the Dragons. Might be height over there, I think. Who's got the football? In fact, it's not, because he's standing right in front of us. So James Coughlin's got the footy. Centre half forward. Handball to Price. Price inside forward 50 to Coughlin. Nothing to get excited about. Lee's kicked one this afternoon. So Coughlin's got it. 35 out. He should pass to Nick Stagg, but he won't. And he will fire at goal. He will not add to their list of individual goal kickers this afternoon, the Dragons, but he may add to the list of goal kickers in general. Coughlin comes in, he kicks a goal, and unlike most of his teammates, he makes no mistake whatsoever. A very nice finish from Lee Coughlin from 35. 23-18, 156 Sandhurst, Gisborne 1-4-10, 22 gone last term. That is thanks to Aussie Disposals on Big Footy, Bendigo's Fresh FM.
Now, he's drilled that like the champion he is, Jacko, but he's missed two early in the game from 20 metres out directly in front.
Yeah,
go figure.
It's hard to comprehend at times, isn't it? He got the difficult one, but he missed two easy ones earlier on today. Leone Patterson has just texted through. Strathfield say with the last goal. So Eaglehawk leading now by just 16 points. So 10 minutes into that last term, Storm could still come back.
Yeah. It's Kangaroo Flat by 3 points over South as well now.
Oh, so it all changes. Lee Coughlin got the takeout from the centre. Long inside forward 50 for the Dragons. No one could mark it. Dogs defence under the pump again. Ruth's got it. He goes on the boot, goes down the wing. Grandstand side, all Dragons. Standing under it, Lockie Tardrew. He's been good today, Tardrew. Like this kid.
Absolute gun.
Now he just weighs up the options and goes with a little pass. Worked well. Got it over to a teammate. Montague gave it back to Tardrew, kicks into the forward pocket, up they go, mark not taken, height, got it out to Cody Price, who fires it goal and missed. Price hadn't kicked one.
I'll go retrieve your pen, Joel.
No, that's all right. One of the boys is going to get it for me. Nice work.
Cody Price
Come
could have
on,
added
Cody.
To it, didn't do it. The dog's clear, and a mark's taken in the back pocket, out of side, might be Trotter who takes it. Goes down the line and finds a teammate who marks on defensive 50. 23 and a half minutes gone. Final term. It's the Dragons 23-19, leading Gisborne 1-4.
Rogers found Grabak with the kick. Grabak, dangerous ball. Exel let in here. Jack Exel did well. Takes the footy, chips it short and finds Coughlin.
Tell you what, it was lucky your pen didn't hit anyone as it went falling out the window there.
Could have been a dangerous projectile, Jacko, couldn't it?
Could have been. Could have got an innocent civilian just strolling past the QEO.
Remember another commentator in years gone by who slammed his pen on the bench a couple of times and it would disappear out the window? That was for different reasons.
Here is Coughlin. He's going to come in from 30 metres out. He kicked the last of the game. We're right behind this one. Leroy comes in and hits the stick.
It was a good shot.
It was a very good shot. It was so good that I called it before it hit the post.
Yep.
It was just tracking beautifully.
Never deviated off hitting the stick.
23-21, 58 Sandhurst, 1-4-10 Gisborne, 24 gone, second term, or last term even, thanks to Bendigo Bank.
So the Dogs have got it on defensive 50, desperately trying to get it out of the danger zone. They can't. They kicked it into the player in front, which was Hamish Lay, and the ball's gone off his body. It's gone out on a full. Who'd it go off? It will be a penalty free kick. The boundary's signalled out on the full. The umpire's conferring with the boundary.
Meanwhile, back to 10 points.
This could be a game changer.
Back to 10 points out there at Flight Centre Park. The Storm are making their charge.
Yes. Yes. Come on, umpire. Whose free kick is it? They can't work it out.
Throw in.
Oh, no, but boundary umpire's put his arms out. Signalled out on the full. And now he's been overruled to throw in. All that for nothing. Throw in just inside, forward 50 for the Dragons. Closing minutes of the game, big win for Sandhurst. Martin got it down to Holmes through the traffic. Kick around the body from Blair Holmes, minor score. Another little one. Tell you what, the way the Dragons are going now, we'll finish up with more points than goals.
Yep.
They're 23-21, 1-5-9, Gisborne 1-4-10. Gisborne will finish up with more points than goals. 25 gone, final term, thanks to Aussie disposals.
Here's Ruth in defensive 50 for the Dogs. 10-point lead to Eagle Hawk in other games, and a 3-point lead to Kangaroo Flat. The close ones this afternoon.
Make that nine, Joel. They've just kicked a goal out there, Kangaroo Flat.
Bugger. Blake, Denise, Exel, looking for the upsets this afternoon. We are on upset watch, and they're none forthcoming. Here is Stagg, inside forward 50. Just go yourself, Nick. Doolan went well. Came out through Baker. He's been good this afternoon. A long tumbling ball. Here's one for the Dogs. Maybe a late opportunity. Running onto the footy is Fraser. Needs it to settle for him. Siren's going to beat him. And as was the case with much of Gisborne's day, it just didn't break right for them. And they have been whacked at the QEO this afternoon, the Gisborne Dogs. 1-4-10 they finish up to Sandhurst. 23-21, 159, 149 points was the margin of victory for the Sandhurst Dragons. Very comprehensive.